Welcome to the webinar on Breakdown Barriers to Knowledge with Amazon Kendra. I am Abhinav Zavdekar, and I am a Principal Solutions Architect focusing on Amazon Kendra at AWS. In an organization, most of the information that in the organization is scattered and proliferated in unstructured data. These are various types of documents, internal wiki pages, websites, they could be product brochures, and whatnot. All of these documents are scattered all over the place, and people have a hard time finding the right information that they are looking for. Additionally, inaccurate keyword search makes it very difficult. And some of these keyword search implementations are also very hard to maintain. There are computers to look after, clusters to maintain, and there is just a lot of manual work involved. And when you don't have an effective way to get the information that you want, there are challenges internally to the organization as well as challenges related to the customers. So people cannot find the information that they are looking for. So employees are not very productive. There could also be risks of liability because employees are not able to find the right policies and compliances that they should be reading about and following. And customers are not able to find information on the websites, or when the customers call center agents, the agents are not able to find the information they need to provide the customers quickly. So customers are not very happy. When someone is looking for information that they need, they really want answers to their questions. So when somebody is looking for the IT support desk, they want to just find out where is the IT support desk. And they just want to find out the answer that it is only first floor. And they are not really interested in getting all kinds of links about IT and support and so on. It is based on these pain points and needs of the customers that Amazon Kendra was designed as an intelligent search solution. Amazon Kendra has a natural language understanding core, or NLU core, and based on machine learning. Amazon Kendra supports natural language queries, so you can directly ask questions. Amazon Kendra will provide instant answers based on document comprehension. So what that means is that if an answer to the user's question lies in one of the documents that is indexed or ingested to Amazon Kendra, Kendra will be able to surface that answer for the user. Kendra is also able to search from tables, and we will be seeing an example in the demo today. Kendra also has the ability to do frequently asked question matching. So if you have question answer pairs, then you can ingest those question answer pairs to Amazon Kendra. And if a query matches one of the questions, it will provide it as part of the response. And then Amazon Kendra will also rank all the results or all the documents based on their relevance to the user's query. The underlying models of Amazon Kendra are already pre-trained on 14 domains, including HR, finance, legal, healthcare and life sciences, and so on. The customers don't need to have machine learning expertise, or they don't need to train models themselves. AWS also does not use customers' data to do any model training. Kendra provides a mechanism for providing feedback. That is, users can vote, press thumbs up, thumbs down, based on the quality of the result that they are seeing, and also based on the number of clicks that they are making. This feedback is taken into account by Kendra in an incremental learning way to improve the relevancy of the search results over time. Kendra also has a number of built-in connectors to well-known data sources such as Microsoft SharePoint, Atlassian Confluence, ServiceNow, Salesforce, and of course, Amazon S3, RDS, and so on. There are many such connectors, and you can take a look at the Amazon Kendra website to get the complete list of connectors. Kendra is secure in the sense that all the information is encrypted in transit and at rest. Amazon Kendra is a fully managed service, so there is no need to manage clusters or instances. It is just you create an index, you connect the data sources, and start searching. Typical use cases of Amazon Kendra include employee experience. So departmental search is a major set of use cases that are handled by Kendra. Customer experience in call centers and self-service portals is another place where Kendra is used by many of our customers. And Kendra is also used by our customers in embedded search in their independent software vendor or ISV or software as a service applications to search their customers' data. With that, I am going to show the demonstration of Kendra. Let's start with the documentation website of AWS documentation. This is the public website that you go to, public portal that you go to when you are searching for information related to AWS services. So I am going to ask a question. What's localhost? And you will get an answer. As you can see, it's a very precise answer. A local zone is an extension of an AWS region in geographic proximity to your users. And as you can see, it is powered by Amazon Kendra. So if you want to experience Amazon Kendra, you can start at docs.aws.amazon.com and search for documentation of your favorite AWS services. Let's look at some more examples. So here we have an index where I have indexed the Wikipedia pages of a few medicines. Let's see how the querying works for Kendra and what kind of results does Kendra show. So let's see what it responds. I'm just looking for paracetamol adult dose. I want to know the paracetamol, how much paracetamol an adult should take, right? So when I ask, it's directly telling me that the adult dose for paracetamol for an adult is 3 to 4 grams. So the user directly gets the answer to the question that they are asking. And this is what we call Kendra suggested answer, or what I talked about, document comprehension based answer that we are getting. Now, here, just to show an example, this is an example of a frequently asked question. So I had ingested one frequently asked question, and you can see the answer over here. And then all of these are documents ranked based on their relevancy to the user query. Now, when it comes to asking questions in natural language, note that in this case, it's not a fully formed question, but it is just a phrase. Now, let me go and see how Kendra responds when the same thing is framed a little bit differently. See, somebody else might ask this question as how much paracetamol to take for an adult. And it again responds with the same answer. And this is the beauty of natural language query support. Let's move on and take a look at how Kendra looks like. So this is the AWS management console for Kendra. And as I explained before, using Kendra is as simple as creating an index, adding data sources, and then you can design and tune your search and you can actually start searching. So in this case, I already have created the index and connected the data sources. So we are just going to start making queries over here. So in this case, what I am going to do is, let's see, I am going to ask for inflation rate in US. And as you can see here, Kendra shows a table of inflation rates in US in the years 2021, 2020, 2019. What more can I do with this? If I want to know the inflation rate in US in 2012, let's see what Kendra responds as. In this case, it responds saying that the inflation rate in 2012 is 2.7%, 2.07%. And as you can see, it was able to find this answer from a table that is part of an HTML page that was indexed into Kendra. So hope you got a flavor or you got a feel for how you can quickly find out what you are looking for and how it is different from just keyword searches. You are able to ask questions in natural language, but then you are also able to ask questions that are not fully formed questions or fully formed sentences, if you will. Here also, it's not a fully formed sentence, but it is able to figure out what you mean in this phrase that you are using for search, right? So with that, I'm going to provide, if you want to know more about Kendra, you can look at these additional sources and find out more about Kendra. And with that, if you have any questions or would like to leave comments, you can also connect with me. Thank you.